Ladies and gents, you beautiful people, I hope you all are having an amazing, beautiful day as always, and I am super excited, guys, to talk about this new Revenant Hunter subclass that is just overall an amazing experience. So in this video, we're gonna take a look at the super, at the grenades, at the aspect, and the fragment. So pretty much we're gonna cover everything. I'm gonna show you some amazing and super fun combinations you can do with the Shatter Dive in combination with all of the freezing abilities. So if you guys do enjoy the video, and only if you do, a like and a sub really does help me out a lot and is very, very appreciated. And keep in mind, guys, there is more beautiful content on the way, PvP builds, PvE builds, including some insane triple 100 stat setups. So don't forget that bell notification button so you don't miss anything. Let's quickly go over all of the abilities, and then I'm gonna jump into a private match and we're gonna take a closer look at these beautiful abilities. Let's take a look at the super. Silence and Squall creates a flash freeze blast that freezes and damages targets, and also creates a stasis storm that slows and damages targets caught inside. And this can be used in so many ways, both in PvP and PvE, guys. This grenade is the first one you're gonna get when you unlock stasis, a grenade that creates walls out of stasis shards to block damage and freeze targets. These walls can be shattered for damage. Then we have the Dusk-filled grenade, a grenade that shatters on impact, leaving behind a field that slows targets and freezes those who do not leave the volume. And the third one, you beautiful people, is called Snap Grenade, and this one is something else. A grenade that freezes on impact and sends another seeker to find and freeze targets. And yes, you guys heard that right, it sends another seeker to find and freeze targets. So we will be testing that out. And then finally, we have the Shatter Dive aspect. Activate while midair to quickly descend and shatter nearby targets on impact. In order to get these guys, for example, the grenades, you have to pretty much finish all the quests that you get, all those legendary quests on Europa. You just follow those and eventually you will get these grenades. The first one you're going to unlock is the Glacier Grenade, and that will be followed with the Cold Snap Grenade. In order to get the Shatter Dive aspect, guys, you have to finish the exotic quest that grants you the Salvation's Grip exotic, right? This one right here, this pretty much freezes everything and it is a lot of fun to use. Once you grab that exotic, it will be a few other steps and then you will be granted the Shatter Dive aspect. As for the dodge, we have the normal dodges, which is the Gambler's Dodge and the Marksman Dodge. We have Triple Jump and Strafe Jump. And then we have Withering Blade. This is like a very fast knife throw, but we have two of them. Now let's talk about these two fragments that I have right here. Pretty much after you finish all the quests, as mentioned, once again, you go to the Exo Stranger and she will have two quests. You can pick those up. And when you complete these two, you will have six of these fragments that you can choose from. Also, keep in mind that you can only pick two at this time. I'm pretty sure that in the future we'll be able to grab all the other ones, but that's how it is right now. So, you know, take a closer look and make a decision that you will not regret once you pick these up. I picked up Whisper of Durance. Slow from your abilities lasts longer. For those abilities that linger, their duration will also increase, and it also gives me plus 10 strength. And the second one is Whisper of Refraction. Defeating slowed or frozen targets grants you class ability energy. So these two fragments together work really, really well. Okay, so the first grenade you're gonna get as you get the stasis ability is gonna give you the ability to create these walls of ice. And if they're close to your enemy, it will freeze them. And then of course you can take them out, or you can shoot the ice itself, as you can see right here, and it does damage too. So there's quite a few ways you can actually utilize these grenades. Right here, you see me throw it at the wall and it still manages to freeze the enemy because they were close to it. And then I'm just shooting the ice, once again, doing damage to the enemy players and absolutely destroying them. You can always use these grenades defensively. Let's say if somebody is rushing you or you're trying to survive from the shots of your enemy, you can always throw them down and create this ice wall in front of you that will literally save your life. The second one is called the Dusk-filled Grenade, and it creates a darkness bubble, like the Titan Super. But this one slows enemies, and if they don't get out really fast, it will also freeze them. This bubble is pretty big and you can use it against enemies around objects, corners, and so on. It's really fun to use and very effective. And of course you can use this one defensively as well. Players that are inside can't slide or run, which makes it a perfect choice against aggressive players. And this brings us to the grenade number 3, Cold Snap Grenade, and this one, ladies and gents, is something else. You throw the nade and it tracks enemies and freezes them. Yeah, you heard me right, it does track them. And if there is more than one enemy, it also will track to those other players. Around corners, behind cover, if used correctly, it can be very good and it has some range too, so it doesn't have to be right next to the enemy. The one thing that can counter it is a perfectly timed jump, but even then, this is not so easy to do. Most of the time, people don't know exactly when you're gonna throw the grenade, so it makes it really hard to avoid it. So all of the grenades we just went over are very, very unique and can be utilized in many different ways depending on what kind of playstyle you have, both in PvP and PvE. So make sure to get these and be sure to test them out, because ladies and gents, these are absolute game changers. And now let's go ahead and move on to the other abilities. So the melees, each hit does 61 damage and slows enemies, but if you get 2 quick hits, it will freeze them. It can also do precision damage, but it has fall off, so you have to aim it above the head, and the further the enemies are, you're gonna have to aim even higher. And it will do 91 damage. And now let's move on to the crazy combinations and super fun stuff, the aspect Shatter Dive. Woo! Once you freeze your targets with any ability, you can do this. Tell me that's not amazing. All you have to do is jump and slam the ground with some dark energy and deal 250 critical damage. There is so many ways you can use this with grenades and even with the super, both for PvP and PvE. And this aspect takes no energy from your abilities or from your super. You just jump and do a long press on circle if you are on PS4, of course, and that's it. Now let's take a look at the super, the silence and squall. If you land it next to your enemies, it will slow and freeze them and spawn kind of a tornado of dark energy that does damage. So they are slowed, frozen and taking damage at the same time. If you get a direct hit, it is a one-shot kill, keep that in mind. And the aspect also works with the super, by the way. As long as you manage to get your enemies frozen, all you have to do is use your shatter dive and go. Yes, that was the sound I make when I do darkness abilities. Don't pay attention to it. But the point is, you will be still doing 250 critical damage and absolutely destroying things both in PvP and PvE. Oh, and one more quick tip. If you get frozen and you pop your super, you instantly get out of it. The whole darkness subclass is very, very unique, and it gives us the ability to play both PvP and PvE in a completely different way, which really gets me excited about the game, right? You can use all those freezing and then the aspects at the same time. You can use all of this to clear huge amounts of adds or just kill the yellow targets. And in PvP, this will give you a lot of new ways to counter your enemy styles. It slows down the aggressive play a lot if you use everything right, of course. And overall, I feel like this is an amazing addition to the game. That's gonna be it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. There's a lot more content on the way. Thank you for all the amazing support. I appreciate every single one of you. And as always, have a crazy, beautiful day.